Hi everybody, so in this video today I'm going to be showing you how to use the free version of Canva to create a book cover for your Amazon KDP book, whether that be a notebook or a journal or whatever it is that you are creating. I'm just going to show you how to use their free templates, which are very intuitive, easy to follow, easy to get on with, instead of using maybe one of the other design tools which are a little bit more tricky to learn. Canva is nice and easy, but the first place that we will start is we'll need to know which dimensions we need our book cover to be. So that's where we come over to the KDP Amazon cover calculator. So we just input our information here, and this is going to give us the dimensions that we need. So I'll leave a link down to this cover calculator below, but it's very simple to use. So we just go through all of this. Are we doing a hardback or a paperback? What interior type are we going to be using? So for this, we're just going to be making a very low content cover, low content book. So we'll go with a black and white interior. Paper type will go white, left to right, page turn direction, measurements of inches, and the interior trim size, we are gonna go for an 8.5 by 11 inches. How many pages will your book have? Obviously, every book could be different, so you put in here how many pages you're gonna have. For this example, let's say 150 pages, and then we're going to calculate the dimensions. And as quick as that, we're gonna get this template created for us. So this tells us up here the full cover will be in inches 17.588 by 11.25. And we can also download the template here, which I recommend you doing. When you download the template, it will be a zip file, so you'll just need to extract that in your downloads of the File Explorer. When we come over to Canva, now we know the dimensions, we can go create design, custom size, and change this to inches. And then just checking again, it was 17.588. And it was 11.25. Create new design. Okay, so this is the book cover size. It's the correct size. And I will now go to my File Explorer, extract that template, and bring that into the upload section of Canva. So you'll get a PNG file in the extracted files folder, which you can literally just drag over to here. Once you click it, it just brings it straight into Canva. And over here on the left, we can go to templates. So there are templates for every kind of thing that you might want to create, from posts to bookmarks to invitations. And of course, we're going to be looking at book covers. So you know what your book is going to be about, so you know where to start with searching through the templates, because there are hundreds of thousands of templates in here. So obviously some keywords are going to be necessary. So for this example, I am going to be making a botany style notebook or journal, let's say. So up here I am going to search for a botany book cover within the templates, and here it brings up 127,300 templates. So tons to choose from. And this is where you can just get your inspiration, let's say, because there are just so many amazing covers on here that, you know, obviously we're not going to just use them directly out of Canva. We are going to make some alterations, but this gives us some ideas. In fact, a lot of these don't actually make me think of botany. So let's maybe change the word botany to floral book cover. That's increased the results. Okay, so these look a little bit more botany, floral designs, don't they, than the other ones perhaps did. So what's brilliant about Canva is they've done a lot of the hard work for us in terms of thinking about design, you know, what colors go well together, what fonts look good with other fonts. That's a really tricky thing. I find that quite difficult myself to match fonts together that work well. I think that's a real skill personally, but it's really great in Canva to get some ideas of how that would look and what works well. For example, here, you know, they've got this kind of scripty font next to this very straight and simple font for the author name. You'll see on most covers that there will be either one, two, or three fonts. And it seems that the rule of thumb is that more than three fonts starts to look messy, complicated, and perhaps not that aesthetically pleasing. In fact, I think sometimes even three fonts can be a bit much. But certainly when it comes to colours and styles, just looking through these templates, it will give you some ideas of what works. So we are just going to use one of these now as a template base. Okay, we're going to use this one as inspiration, but we are going to change it and make it a little bit more interesting. And we're also going to add an author name. So we're going to customize this template. So let's just highlight this to start with. And if we could just press Control and C, we'll copy it. Move over here and Control and V. And now that brings in that background for us. Now with the uploaded template, if we add this on, this will show us exactly where all of the elements are, so how thick the spine will be, where the barcode is going to be, and obviously this is our front cover and this is our back cover. So we've got this to kind of just use and check that we are putting things in a good position. So I always like to put a spine on first, just so that I've got that central point added. So we go to elements and just add a line. Move this line around to 90 degrees. And let's make this much thicker, maybe about 35, let's say. That seemed quite a good guess there. If we zoom right in, we can see, look at that, that was amazing. So you can see that's fitting nicely on that spine there. Now the pink is the kind of bleed area. Now when Amazon are printing, they're saying that within this pink range is where the edge of the book will be, or where the edge of the spine will be. So I think actually we'll make this line a bit thicker. Let's go 45, and then we're going into the bleed area as well. So I am going to extend this up to the top and the bottom. Zoom back out. Now that's where our spine will be. The barcode, I mean, it depends what kind of design you're gonna have, but let's just put a little square over the barcode for now, just to remind us that that is an area of the design that we kind of need to keep clear. Now we can remove that template and we've got our cover with a spine and we know where the barcode will go. So let's go back to this template. Now, if we want to highlight the actual elements all in one go, we can just highlight the whole template. We can group those together, Control C to copy them, and then Control V to bring them in to this document. Now, these are currently one element. So we can bring this onto our cover. And as we can quite quickly see, because of our dimensions, these dimensions here, the flowers are going to the edge of this notebook, but on our dimensions, obviously they look like they're just floating about, which is not ideal. And we're obviously going to change this anyway, because this is not our design. We're just going to use this as inspiration. So what I would do is copy the page, and then the one that we work on and change, we can do whatever we want to, but we've still got the kind of original here if we want to have a look at it and refer to it. In this case, it's very simple, but with some of the templates, you know, they are a lot more involved. So it's always nice, I think, to just keep a copy of the original in your document, and then you've got something to refer to. If you don't like what you're changing, you can go back to the original. So now let's ungroup these elements and let's decide what we're going to call our notebook. So in this case, this is going to be aimed at a botany student. So I'm going to change this over to environmental science. I'm going to make this much smaller, and we have got the scenario where this is in the way now. And as you can see, you get these little guidelines as well, which help you to realize exactly where you are on the page. So we want to have that centralized on the cover. And these numbers, 0.406, is showing us that the lines are now equally spaced above and below the text. With such a big word like environmental, that font I think is not working anymore. Notebook, it was fine. Environmental science, that's too difficult to read, even at this scale. Imagine seeing it on the page of Amazon where there are four books in a row. You're never going to be able to read that. So we need to change our font. So up here we can change our font. And again, we'll need to pick a font that has not got the pro symbol. So spend a bit of time and decide what kind of font that you like. Okay, I've gone with this font, which is called Libre Baskerville. So now I want to change these floral elements. So again, we go to elements and we're gonna search elements and we're gonna search the word leaf. And we are gonna be looking for ones that are not pro because we haven't got a pro account. Though I would recommend it if you're gonna spend a long time on Canva using all of their facilities because it does make a huge difference. And we're gonna add a leaf in here. So we can start to delete these guys. Now down here, we can see we've got this cover coming over, which we don't want. So we can go position backward and that will hide that now, just behind our spine. I'm gonna select this element, control copy, control V, and I'm going to flip it and bring it over here. I'm going to control V again. I'm going to rotate it slightly. And I'm gonna change the color of the text as well. Now that we have got lots of elements on the page, what's nice is when we click on text and we click on fonts and colors, it will give us the photo colors. So it shows us here that these are the colors, these are the greens that are already on the document. So what's really nice is you can just match them quite easily. So if I wanna give it a nice dark green font, that's very easy to do. Obviously some of these are just going to get lost on that background, but if we wanted to go for a really nice dark green font, we can. Let's make it even bigger here. Again, recentralize that and let's change these little elements as well. We can have one this way. Let's just zoom in. I think we need some kind of background behind this text to make it pop a little bit more. So let's go to elements and let's pick out a shape, this kind of square shape that's got a nice rounded edge. And if we bring this over again, I like to zoom in when I'm doing this fiddly stuff, and we can bring this size up and along, position it to the back, backward, backward, backward. And let's change the color of the text, maybe to, I think, a bright white actually. Color of the text box. Let's just see. A darker green, maybe like a darker green. Let's just bring that out a little bit and have a look. Yeah, I think that pops out a lot more now. Then we'll move this leaf down slightly so it's not touching. And I don't think we need these leaves on the top and the bottom of the text. I like the way that leaf is just coming over here. I think that's nice. It's just coming into the text box there, and that one just needs to be brought up a little bit. And now I'm starting to quite like the design. So I'm going to add a pen name to my notebook. So add a subheading. And for this book, I will use the pen name Holly Drake. And we want to change that font as well. Let's find a font that goes nicely with the other. Yeah, I'm fine with that. And I'm also gonna change the color to green. And that can be a lot smaller. And we want to centralize that as well. So I'm quite happy with that front cover now. And now I'm just gonna think about the back cover as well. So for the back cover, I want to keep it quite simple and elegant. So I'm gonna go with maybe some single leaves. So let's just go back to the leaf element. Yeah, that's a nice idea. A lot of these are pro elements, we can see. Let's try and find, so this one isn't a pro element. So these are just like shadows of leaves. I quite like that idea. Let's see if it works. So I'm just gonna bring this down. Okay, so I want to select the box behind to get rid of it now. So as you can see, when you just select here, we can't grab that text, that little gray box. But if we use the control key, we can get to the one behind it. Just delete that, we don't need that anymore. And I'm also gonna delete page 2, because I don't need that anymore. I am quite happy with how that looks now. If you'd like some help with getting interiors for your books, for example, just some plain lined interiors and some templates and things, I actually do have some available on my website. I've got notebook interiors, different ones, college ruled, wide ruled, handwriting paper, narrow ruled. These are free templates. I've got a cover planner and an interior as well here as well, which are all accessible through Canva. There's a link in the description down below how to get to my website if you are interested in that. But now what we want to do is download this. So we go share, download, and we want this to be PDF print, best for printing. We want the high quality. PDF print and download. Now you've got your cover ready to upload into Amazon KDP. And like I said, if you want some help with interiors, just grab them from the link down below and that will give you a head start if you are quite new to KDP. I hope you found this tutorial useful and I'll see you in the next one.